So the Pro Act, or parts of it, have a chance at passing through the infrastructure reconciliation bill. The only things that can pass through reconciliation are things that directly affect the federal budget. So what are the things that have a chance of passing through reconciliation and the PRO Act? The CWA has a handy budget reconciliation fact sheet, and they believe that there are four major provisions that can make it through budget reconciliation. The first is to restore and enhance tax deduction for union dues. Previously, union members were able to deduct taxes. Trump, quote-unquote, tax cut raised taxes for union members because it disallowed us from being able to deduct our dues from taxes. The second, it would end tax deductibility of the costs of hiring permanent strike replacements. This would prevent businesses from deducting from their taxes expenses incurred in fighting workers' efforts to unionize, the hiring of strike replacements, and any other expenses used to fight the workers or their unions. And it's insane that you can deduct taxes for that. Three, it would reduce the misclassification of employees as independent contractors. The current tax code allows companies to continue to misclassify workers as independent contractors, even if the IRS determines they are employees. The solution is to establish tax penalties for companies that misclassify employees as independent contractors. Fourth and finally, civil penalties for unfair labor practices. One of the main reasons why we need labor reform right now is that companies only receive a slap on the wrist for violating workers' rights and committing unfair labor practices.